Anthony here from Rev 3 Games at PAX East. We're at the Clay booth. I'm here with Nels. You are the lead designer of Mark of the Ninja.
That's correct.
And this is the new one from you guys. You are most known for the Shank series.
Yep.
And this is kind of a change for you.
This is definitely a very different beast. Mark of the Ninja is, like you said, like it's a straight up 2D stealth game. Like obviously it still has those things that Clay is really about, like really fluid 2D animation.
Yeah.
It's like, you know, really, really good game feel, like super tight controls. But what you're doing in it is actually pretty different. You're creeping around, being a sneaky ninja. Obviously, Shank is very, you know, like second by second action, bloody beat 'em up. And this is a bit more intentional, deliberate.
So 2D stealth. This is kind of interesting. We played through the first level.
Yep.
And it's got some really interesting mechanics. Explain how like light and dark works, and explain how the sound works.
Yeah, totally. So we wanted the challenge in the game to not really come from having to figure it out. Because I find like sometimes stealth can be kind of inaccessible because there's so much going on and it's all invisible, right?
Yeah.
So we wanted to make it really, really clear what was happening from a stealth perspective. So then that's just another tool in your arsenal to use. So the character himself, like when he's in light, his whole build, his whole appearance changes. So he's like, he's got this blue detailed thing. When he's in darkness, he's black with these white outlines. So unlike kind of an awkward like light gem that you might see in some other stealth games, it's like perfectly obvious right there in the middle of the screen.
Yeah.
You're hidden or not. And then with all the sound, whenever a noise is made that enemies can detect, we put these big white rings out on the screen so you know exactly, oh, if I break that light, that noise is going to propagate. That guard will hear it, but that guard won't. So this one guy will come over and investigate. I nail him. The other guy is just totally oblivious, hanging out. Then I sneak up behind him, stab him in the guts, and continue on my merry ninja way.
Yeah, and let's talk about how you can kill and stab some people in the guts. Because obviously Shank was known for being super violent. This has got a lot of that violence there too, but it's definitely harder to pull off, and
yes,
it's more situational.
Yes, it is very situational. I mean, even from the outside of the game, basically for every kind of movement position the ninja can be in, like on the ground, on a ceiling, on a wall, on a grappling hook point, he has a stealth kill he can execute from there. And actually, each of the stealth kills has kind of like an input. We call them active stealth kills.
Okay.
There's like this input challenge you have to do. If you do it right, your kill is very fast. The guy doesn't make any noise when he dies, but if you mess it up, he kind of like has a choking gurgle, and then that might draw the attention of other guards, and then you have to deal with that situation. And that's just straight out of the box, right?
Yeah.
And then further on, you can unlock different stealth kills, which lets you do it in other kind of more specific contextual areas, like out of a hiding point, from like straight from behind a door, and then you actually kill the guy, pull him back through the door, so the door's still closed, no one else could see in there.
Yeah, it was super cool to see how the stealth thing made the transition to 2D, because all the stuff I expected to be there was there.
Like
I'm hiding bodies, I'm like knocking out lights, I'm distracting guards, but the 2D aspect of it just makes it, I can see the layout, I can tell what's going on.
Yeah.
Right? It's, like, it becomes more of a puzzle than a, I can't really see everything, I don't know what's going on.
Yeah.
You know, and now it's like, I can look at the situation, figure it out, and then try to solve it.
It's a puzzle, kind of, but it's a puzzle with like multiple different solutions that you kind of choose how you want to approach them, how you're going to engage with them, all that kind of stuff.
Very cool. So when are we going to be able to get our hands on Mark of the Ninja?
This summer.
And it's XBLA?
On Xbox Live Arcade.
Beautiful. And if people want to keep up with you guys, where do they do it?
Just clayentertainment.com or Twitter @clay or markoftheninja.com.